Are you interested in learning how to sell Ambit in a way that's easier than the awkwardness that comes from hitting up friends and family or trying to recruit the waiter every time you and your family go out to dinner? Real quick, if you're making these Ambit advertising mistakes, then make sure you follow my entire lesson here. The mistakes you might make are using the Ambit service line and opportunity in your social media posts. Here's an example of an Ambit consultant showing a pic about her services on Facebook. This only results in losing sales because her Facebook followers will Google the Ambit Energy name and most likely buy from someone else. She's also talking about the business opportunity way too soon on this image. It's annoying. It doesn't bring any value to her followers, and it ends up with more people blocking you than asking for more information. If you're anything like me and many others who struggled initially to make sales in network marketing, you're probably starting to ask the question, is selling Ambit worth it? Most of what you've been taught about joining Ambit Energy hinges on prospecting people that have no interest in what you sell. It's hard to build an Ambit team or help customers from a pool of uninterested friends and family, right? Is there a source of profitable retail sales existing in your family? Unlikely, and I'm sure you're feeling frustrated about it all. Is there a more effective Ambit business plan? Yes, there's a more effective way as you learn how to make money with Ambit that allows you to target people who don't know you yet, but who are definitely interested in solving the problems you and your Ambit services solve. You can't sell Ambit online by dated offline methods because these advertising ideas are just ineffective in today's world. I imagine you're here with me because you're beyond frustrated with the results you've seen so far. Inside your Ambit networking business opportunity, you've listened to your upline tell you about the path to success. Things like use the 3-foot rule, make a list of friends and family, use Facebook chat, and other time-consuming social media tactics. Recent feedback from someone reaching out to me for help was this. They said, my top 3 frustrations are 1, I feel like this is way harder than it should be. 2, I'm getting nasty comments after posting Ambit services on Facebook or TikTok or other social media. And 3, it seems like I'm losing friends and family because I keep asking them to look at my business. The interesting thing about these Ambit promotion ideas is that they have nothing to do with marketing at all. I mean, back in 1985, this may have made sense because the average person then didn't have access to the type of money it took to advertise on TV and radio. Today with the internet, there's no reason for you to hit up friends and family who have no earthly interest in buying your services or joining your Ambit business opportunity. As more Ambit reps go online to find prospects, it's resulted in the average Ambit rep getting the same results as they did when prospecting offline. Big, fat rejection. This is because the normal advice, for example, is to go on social media and post pictures of you and your Ambit services. This is a big mistake. Avoid this method as you learn how to make money with Ambit. The reason this doesn't work is because it goes against how successful internet marketing works. So in order to teach you how to sell Ambit online, I need to first show you what it looks like to sell anything online successfully. So why do most people fail at selling Ambit services online? Well, imagine this for a moment. You walk into a networking event where people have gathered to get to know one another and possibly exchange business cards. For some reason, you decide it's a great idea to start shouting at the top of your lungs, I'm in a really awesome company called Ambit. We have the best services that have ever been produced. On top of that, we have a fantastic business opportunity where you can come in and make a ton of money. As a matter of fact, it's the best business opportunity to have ever been invented. And I'll show you how to make money in Ambit. You just watch. Now, I'm sure you're having a good laugh thinking about doing this. You wouldn't ever dream of doing something so ridiculous and obnoxious, right? But this is one way people are taught to sell Ambit online. Often we're told by company training or our upline that one of the most effective Ambit promotion ideas is posting on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, and other social media sites. For example, use Instagram to post pictures of ourselves talking about our services, or go on Facebook and talk about how to make money with Ambit. This is the equivalent of going into that room and screaming at the top of your lungs how great your business is. It's too soon in the relationship that you're trying to build with your prospect. If you wouldn't do it inside a one-on-one conversation because you know it feels weird and pushy, why would you do the same thing on the internet? Using internet marketing best practices is always the best way to sell Ambit online. The best way to alienate your prospects offline is to use the 3-foot rule or to bug friends and family with a service they're not currently looking for. A great way to alienate your prospects online is to jump on social media and basically yell about your services and business opportunity that no one is actively searching for. I encourage you to stop listening to what your company is telling you about this. They're training you to hard sell and to ask for the sale way before you deserve it. Network marketing companies across the board teach these hokey ways to market. It's a better idea to think of yourself as an entrepreneur as opposed to a representative for Ambit. You really should think like an entrepreneur and learn everything you can about educating first and selling second. Is selling Ambit Energy worth it? Well, not when you give up sales on social media. Hosting your services on social media doesn't work because you're giving away sales. So how are you doing that? Well, what you're doing is you're showing your Ambit name, talking about the services right there on the social posts. And then, even if someone has a remote interest in your Ambit services, they have no loyalty to you, the person just posting random pics on social media. What they'll do is go to Google, do a little bit of research, and if they ever join Ambit or purchase services, they'll likely do it with someone they found through their Google search, the person who posted helpful information. Build value, solve problems, and serve others to successfully sell Ambit. Internet marketing is sort of like dating. Instead of asking someone to marry you the moment you first meet them, showing your services on Instagram or TikTok is trying to get married without dating first. Ask your prospects to go on the equivalent of a lunch date first by focusing on the problem that your services can solve for them. The result is that you'll attract people who are actively searching for the solution that your Ambit services solve. Think about it. Who's a better Ambit prospect? The cashier at your local supermarket, just because she's 3 feet from you? Your coworker, just because he's on your friends and family list? Or other like-minded people searching right now for how to solve the problem your Ambit services solve? Find those like-minded people by becoming the trusted advisor of your prospects by focusing on the problem you solve and showing them how you can solve it for them. Now, at this point, your brain can play tricks on you and say that what I'm talking about here is way too much hard work. It's easy to tell yourself that creating valuable content and helping your prospects solve problems takes too much time. But is it really too hard to do? And does it really take too much time? Think about it for just a moment. You create content all the time. In fact, you do it when you try to make money with Ambit by telling people why you love it and why the services will help them. It's just that you're talking to the wrong people by posting those service pictures or yelling about how they can make money. It's like trying to tell a vegan all the benefits of eating meat. No matter how great your argument is, it's falling on deaf ears, right? As you enter the world of internet marketing and apply it to your Ambit business, you'll archive information that's actually helpful to your target audience by placing it on a blog post, a YouTube video, or a social media post. You're putting it in a place where people who are searching for ways to solve the problem your Ambit services solve can find it. Now your next potential pitfall to doing all this correctly and successfully is that you might say, hey Matt, I'm not an expert in my niche yet, so I can't do this. You might wonder why would anyone listen to you, right? No worries. The solution is to take what I call the journey approach to selling Ambit. The journey approach is this. You're excited about the problem you're solving with Ambit. So just tell others what you're learning and that they can come with you as you learn more. That's all you're doing. Don't falsely set up yourself as an expert. You don't need to be an expert. Just be honest and tell people that you've learned a few things that excite you, that you're committed to learning more, and you invite them to join you on your journey as you do. To do this, take some time to research the problems people have that your Ambit services solve. What do they want to learn more about? What do they want to know how to do? What problems do they have? What worries them each day when they wake up? Now offer tips and ideas that help them overcome these problems, fears, and anxieties. Don't try to sell Ambit yet. Don't mention Ambit, your services, at all at this point. Don't mention your compensation plan or the business. First, offer general tips, ideas, and solutions that are relevant to the niche that Ambit has put you in, like saving money on energy, right? I mean, something as simple as that. The people finding your online content will see you as a helpful person, not some weirdo trying to get them into some strange business deal. You see the difference against the stuff you've been doing that isn't working for you? Once you build that trust with your prospects, they'll want more information about the full solution to their problems. Then you slide your Ambit services in front of them and position those services as the solution. And you're talking to the right people who will make the purchase from you. Now, there are some pros and cons to MLM that you should know about, because if you don't, they could hurt your efforts at selling Ambit online. The advantages are that network marketing gets you started in business. It exposes you to personal development ideas and books, and it shows you how to handle rejection. The biggest problem, though, is that there's no uniqueness between you and other Ambit consultants. Everyone in Ambit is told to do the same thing. Each Ambit rep gets the same replicated website. This means there's nothing different about you and the thousands of other Ambit consultants running around screaming on social media about how great the services and the company are. You're in competition with all those Ambit consultants posting the same obnoxious posts. Marketing success comes from being unique. Using online marketing correctly allows you to get creative about how to sell Ambit. As long as you aren't the get-rich-quick type and you don't try to cut corners, you'll start outselling and out-recruiting everyone else in your company. The true long-term solution to this negative aspect of network marketing is to set up your own online platform and sell Ambit from it. One of the easiest ways to get started is to build a blog and then revolve all of your social media accounts around it. You bring up the problems on the blog that your Ambit services solve. You point your social media contacts back to your blog for the solutions and more helpful tips. And then your blog allows your visitors to opt in as email leads in exchange for further helpful tips and info. You now have real people to contact and sell Ambit to. The process I just took you through is how every successful online business operates. There really is no secret. You need traffic, meaning you need people who are interested in solving the problem that your services and business solve. You need those people to come to your blog and start to feel as if they know and can trust you as they become receptive to your recommendations. Now you might say, but Matt, I'm not sure if talking about the Ambit brand on my own blog is allowed. If you're saying that, then you're not understanding what I'm saying here. You never ever want to mention the Ambit brand or the service name on your blog or your social media platforms. Never. That's the big mistake I've been talking about through this entire training. You talk about the general problems your services solve. Your company can't tell you that you can't do that. Now you might say, but Matt, I see a lot of people using social media as their home on the internet. Yes, you do. Many people use social media only. And it's a mistake because you don't own any of your social media profiles. If you ever violate the terms of service on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, or any other social media platform that comes along and is the next big thing, they can shut your account down and bam, all your fans, all your traffic is gone. I'm not saying you shouldn't use social media. You must use social media. What I'm saying is that social media should revolve around an online asset you do own, which is your blog. Building your online presence on social media only is like building your house on sand, but building your online presence on your blog is like building your home on bedrock. Using an online presence that revolves around your blog solves every problem you'll ever encounter when selling Ambit. Using the network marketing strategy I'm detailing out for you here solves all the problems of direct sales while helping you create uniqueness. Once you use your own blog as your online home base, no other Ambit consultants will be able to compete with you. While other consultants are doing silly infomercials on social media, you'll educate and attract real prospects who come to love you and your message. They'll start buying from you. One last benefit to all this is that you can eventually create additional sources of income. This gets exciting when you discover that building inside the niche that Ambit puts you in allows you to sell other things that relate to that niche in the future. Remember, you own the traffic from your blog and the resulting email subscriber base that it builds for you. So you can expand beyond only selling Ambit and become a true entrepreneur if you want to. Even if you don't want to do that right away, it sets you up to add in these other income streams down the line, maybe 2 to 5 years from now. You might make money from ad income, Amazon, affiliate products, and other service offers. You might create a coaching program that people pay $2,000 or $5,000 to join. You can just get creative and do whatever you want and expand your potential for revenue exponentially over time. Would you like to start to enroll 3 to 7 new customers and team members into your Ambit Energy business every week? I have more education that teaches you how to take everything I've talked about on this training and do exactly that. Click the link in this video's description if you're watching on YouTube, or put your information into the form I've placed near this video or audio on my blog, and I'll shoot you a 5-day video training that helps you enroll 3 to 7 new customers and team members into your Ambit business every week.